That whatever it takes for every child, but really we mean that. You know, it's not something that we just say, and we don't take that lightly. At the end of the day, I want them to love school. I want them to love and appreciate that our school is willing to go above and beyond to do whatever we can to teach them. But my bottom line goal is to teach them to love school and love learning and become a lifelong learner, just like I try to be.
I'm a little bit country.
I'm a little bit rock and roll.
I love the height of feeling of a great drum call.
When I sing my alma mater, I feel it all night long.
I love my school with all my heart and soul.
I know I'm gonna be all right.
Wherever I go.
I'm a little bit country.
And a little bit rock and roll.
About losing your rate of pride, then you need rate of pride alert. Just press the button on the class of 89 Spirit Stick, and we will send help immediately.
Rate of pride alert.
Help! My rate of pride is fallen and it can't get up!
It's okay, Miss Timmerman. Help is on the way.
Turn up! Rate of pride, we got some. Rate of pride, we got
some. To order your rate of pride alert, just call 1-800-RP-ALERT. Rate of pride is justified.
Looking for a school can be like super overwhelming. You kind of have those fears as a parent that, oh my gosh, the school that I'm gonna pick, it's gonna determine their future and everything else. And, you know, it's a big choice that you have because you wanna make sure you're gonna put them in a school where they can continue their whole journey. I'm really super glad we started at Nettleton. It was relief that we had found a school where we felt comfortable sending our child. I felt like any situation he'd get put into, he would be able to succeed.
Uh-oh, guess what day it is? Guess what day it is? Huh? Anybody? Julie, hey, guess what day it is? Oh, come on, I know you can hear me.
Mike. What day is it, Mike?
Hey, Leslie, guess what day it is?
It's game day.
Woo-hoo!
Jalen, how happy are students that go to Nettleton?
I'll say happier than DJ on game day.
Game day!
Be happy, yeah. Be a Raider. Raider pride is justified.
So don't forget it.
Mr. Miller lost his voice. No problem. I'll send in the replacements.
Woo! Woo, Daddy Mercy! Mercy, woo, Daddy! Handsome Johnny! How the heck do you edit on this thing?
Mr. McGrew, you're in photo booth.
What? This son of a...
Hey, that's all right. Good try. But I'll take it from here. Raider pride!
It's justified!
They say being a Raider is about more than just going to school. They say being a Raider is about our community, about tradition. Kindergarten at Nettleton is about teachers that I love, learning that is fun. It's really about pride in what we do and who we are becoming. Raider pride is justified. Raider pride forever.
Nettleton students will do anything for the Spirit Stick.
Would you ding-dong ditch Coach Massey?
That old man? Any day.
Dadgummit!
Would you get tased by Officer Watts?
Yes.
Okay. Raider pride.
Would you cannonball into the Raider River?
Would I? Hold my mullet.
We are Raiders. Bum ba dum bum 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 bum.
Did you hear that?
Yeah, it sounds like we're in a Raider Pride ad. That means something awesome's about to happen.
Raider Pride, brother, fire the thing in here. Dinger!
Hey, run.
At Nettleton, we got that Raider Pride.
Because Raider Pride is justified.
We are Raiders. Bum ba dum bum 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 bum.
What the heck?
Yeah, I'm a junior. Does it matter? You do that for me? Really? Oh, how like that.
Who are you talking to?
It's DJ from Nettleton.
That sounds like a really good deal.
DJ from Nettleton at 3 in the morning? Who is this?
It's DJ from Nettleton.
What are you wearing, DJ from Nettleton?
A black and gold Raider Pride shirt.
She sounds hideous.
Well, it's DJ, so.
Another reason why Raider Pride is justified.
The Nettleton Raiders present Messing with Miller.
There he is.
Let's get him.
Let's go get that jabroni. Y'all check this out.
Nettleton High School, feed your Raider pride.
There comes a time in the life of every Nettleton student when they hear it.
Raider pride!
A higher calling, an invitation to achieve, to excel, to be a part of something bigger than themselves. It's the calling of Raider pride. And it's alive and well at Nettleton, where Raider pride is justified.
I first noticed it when he started school here at Nettleton.
There he is.
Who's got that Raider pride? We've got that Raider pride, brother.
So we're gonna pick up today chapter 23. Can anybody tell me what page that's on?
89.
Salo, why are you the way that you are?
But you know, some of the stuff he does is actually pretty cool.
It's Jimmy.
Who's Jimmy?
Raider Pride can't save you from becoming Mr. Miller, but it can give you the best high school experience ever. Raider Pride is justified.
Yeah, we Raiders got the comfort ship, a loaded. Everybody wants to be a show, a voting. Raider Pride in the building, yeah, yeah, I know it. Ah, yeah, Raider Nation till the day it's over.
Raider Pride, just a fact, got it on my side. Six side, be the guy, run up and you get a high. Press us the ball, and I'ma score it like.
What y'all know about fifth period Raider Pride? Hop up on the field, you might just have a juke and job. Every day, yeah, I rip the five. Cause yeah, you know we fifth period, yeah, we make it live.
Why?
Tell them what you got.
I got that Raider pride.
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 I got that Raider pride. Tell them what you got.
I got that Raider pride.
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 I got that Raider pride. Tell them what you got.
I got that. I got that. I got that Raider pride.
Tell them what you got.
Yeah, I got that. I got that. I got that Raider pride.
Our school's pretty amazing.
I know. Kind of makes you just want to
break into song.
I like the faculty.
I like MTV.
I like the principal.
Although he paddled me.
We love the black hole.
We love our sports teams.
Raider pride, Raider pride, Raider pride, Raider pride.
I like the lunchroom.
I like learning.
We love Nettleton.
We love our family.
Raider pride, Raider pride, Raider pride, Raider.
Whatever.
Come on, Tyler, you act like you have no Raider pride at all.
Listen, sister, I'll take my Raider pride and I'll stick it right up your...
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Here you go. Try this. Better?
Much better.
You're not you when you don't have Raider pride.
In.
Three things we Nettleton Raiders love. We love our school, we love America, and we love getting our trucks fixed up at Russell's Truck Accessories. Russell's Truck Accessories is the greatest place on earth to make your truck look sharp. If Russell's were a bird, they'd be a bald eagle. If they were a nation, they would be the United States of America. The greatest nation on God's green earth. Thanks in part to Russell's Truck Accessories.
Nettleton students will do anything for the Spirit Stew.
Would you ding-dong ditch Coach Massey?
That old man? Any day.
Dad, coming!
Would you get tased by Officer Watts?
Yes.
Okay. pride.
Would you cannonball into the Raider River?
Would I? Hold my mullet.
When the Raiders have wrecks, they call collision repair. Back in 1986, Nettleton's Jeff Edgar was smashing baseballs. He hit the first home run in Raider baseball history. These days, he's fixing smashed cars at Collision Repair. Collision Repair's staff is second to none, and their facilities are world class. They'll get you fixed up and back on the road in no time. Collision Repair, it's where the Raiders go when the Raiders have wrecks.
We are Raiders. Bum, ba-dum-bum-bum-bum-bum.
Did you hear that?
Yeah, it sounds like we're in a Raider Pride ad. That means something awesome's about to happen.
Raider Pride, brother. Fire the thing in here. Dinger!
Hey, run.
At Nettleton, we got that Raider Pride.
Because Raider Pride is justified.
We are Raiders. Bum, ba-dum-bum-bum-bum-bum.
What the heck?
Junior, does it matter? You do that for me? Really? Oh, I like that.
Who are you talking to?
It's DJ from Nettleton.
That sounds like a really good deal.
DJ from Nettleton at 3 in the morning? Who is this?
It's DJ from Nettleton.
What are you wearing, DJ from Nettleton?
A black and gold Raider Pride shirt.
She sounds hideous.
Well, it's DJ, so.
Another reason why Raider Pride is justified.
A lot has changed since the 1950s, but one thing has remained the same. Sue's Drugstore is still keeping Nettleton healthy. Albert and Shirley Sue founded Sue's Drug in 1959, and today their grandson Tyler continues their tradition of fast, friendly, professional service. Sue's Drugstore, keeping Raider Pride healthy and alive since 1959.
The Nettleton Raiders present Messing with Miller.
There he is.
Let's get him.
Let's go get that jabroni. Y'all check this out.
What a jabroni.
Nettleton High School, feed your Raider Pride.
From the first time you held on to the time you let go, life is a series of unforgettable firsts, the ones that are planned and the ones that take you by surprise. We celebrate and support these firsts as we travel this journey with you, because firsts are what life is all about. First Community Bank, where community comes first.
I first noticed it when he started school here at Nettleton.
There he is!
Who's got that Raider Pride? We've got that Raider... Shh!
Raider Pride, brother. Raider Pride, brother.
So we're going to pick up today chapter 23. Can anybody tell me what page that's on?
89.
Salo, why are you the way that you are?
But you know, some of the stuff he does is actually pretty cool.
It's Jimmy. Who's Jimmy?
Raider Pride can't save you from becoming Mr. Miller, but it can give you the best high school experience ever. Raider Pride is justified.
For Terry Gray, rice farming isn't a profession. It's a way of life. As owner of Delaplaine Seed Company, Terry's been the region's rice tech leader for more than a decade. In the summer, Terry's not behind a desk. He can be found in rice fields giving advice, or he can be on your farm helping you put more bushels in your tanks and money in your pocket. From securing your hybrid rice to free on-farm delivery, let Terry help you be more profitable this season. Delaplaine Seed Company.
They They say being a Raider is about more than just going to school. They say being a Raider is about our community, about tradition. Kindergarten at Nettleton is about teachers that I love, learning that is fun. It's really about pride in what we do and who we are becoming. Raider pride is justified. Raider pride forever.
Hi, I'm Trish Merritt with A Beautiful Mess Salon. I'm a proud graduate of Nettleton High School and a big supporter of the Raiders. I've been at A Beautiful Mess since we opened in September of 2015. I love to take care of my Raider family, like I take care of the legendary Miss T. So feel free to set up an appointment today. Call 870-520-6039. Raider pride is justified.
Raider pride forever.
Looking for a school can be like super overwhelming. You kind of have those fears as a parent that, oh my gosh, the school that I'm gonna pick, it's gonna determine their future and everything else. And, you know, it's a big choice that you have because you wanna make sure you're gonna put them in a school where they can continue their whole journey. I'm really super glad we started at Nettleton. It was relief that we had found a school where we felt comfortable sending our child. I felt like any situation he'd get put into, he would be able to succeed.
And good evening, as we are about to have some Lady Raider basketball action here at Nettleton Gymnasium. I'm Cameron Salo, and joined by Daniel Golden as the Nettleton Lady Raiders take on the Southside Southerners. Daniel, what do you think about this matchup?
Boy, I think it'll be a good matchup. They're both Nettleton Raiders are 3-1, while Southside's 2-1 coming into this game. I think we'll have a close game. It'll be hard fought, and hopefully the Raiders will pull it out in the end.
Yeah, I think this is going to be a very good competitive match, or game, should I say. The Lady Raiders coming off an impressive victory last week, as I think it was Wakiria Daniels had the team high. And, you know, I hope they can go in with a full head of steam and continue to play at that great state, current state champion level. And as the starting lineups are about to be announced, we'd like to thank our sponsors, First Community Bank, Russell's Truck Accessories, Shadrachs, Collision Repair, Delta Seed Plane Company, Sue's Drugstore, Consolidated Insurance, and Trish Merritt from A Beautiful Mess Salon. And as the starting lineups are about to be announced, we would just like to say thank you for joining us here on Nettleton Television. And you are in it for a treat as we are about to watch some great basketball. And as the Southerners, our starters are being announced, we have number 10, Callie Robbins. We've got number 4, Olivia Allen. Number 5, Julian Stevens. And number 13, Kami Jenkins. And to end it, number 14, Brett Gardner. And now for your Lady Raiders, our starting lineup is number 1, Layla Eliotti. Number 4, Demaria Daniels. Number 3, Briley Pena. Number 25, Natasia Oliver. And number 24, Wakiria Daniels. And as the game is about to tip, we are getting a nice pep talk from Coach Smith to the Lady Raiders, getting them warmed up and excited, pumped for action. And as we are about to go to tip off, it looks like Wakiria Daniels for the Nettleton Lady Raiders is going to jump. And number 14, Gardner, or excuse me, number 13, Jenkins. And the tip, and the Southerners get the first possession as number 14, Gardner's taking up the court as she gets a high screen for number 13. A nice roll action, but cannot keep the ball in her hands. Kicks it to the corner to number 10, Robbins. And now number 5, Stevens, kicks it to number 14, Gardner. A lot of ball movement from the Southerners. Number 5's got the ball, a nice positioning, and took a little double dribble. You cannot do that as number 13, Jenkins, gets the turnover. And now the Lady Raiders inbound the ball with a little pace as number 4, Demario Daniels, gets a pass from Briley Pena. Wakuri Daniels kicks it to Riley Pena, moving the ball a lot, and kicks it to the corner of Layla Eliotti. Just moving around the ball, trying to get a great shot. And they're just doing some great. Oh, and a nice move from Demaria Daniels. Man, a nice spin off the defender to finish with the floater. And it appears that number five, Julian Stevens, is down with an injury. A heck of a move by Demaria Daniels. What do you think?
Yeah, I mean, you couldn't ask for a better move. Yes. Drive to the bucket, do a spin move around her, and then score.
Yeah.
What more do you ask from a girl?
Unfortunately, though, number five is down for the Southerners, and let's hope it's nothing serious. We are going to go to commercial break. This is Nettleton Lady Raiders on NTV. Back, and it seems that number five, Julian Stevens, has got off the court, which is great to see. I'm glad that she isn't, getting carted off or something even worse, but it's good to see that she got up. And now it appears that somebody has subbed in for, I think it was number 35, Madison Gilmore, as a steal by the Lady Raiders. And it appears that Wakuri Daniels gets a little bump, which results in the ball getting knocked out of bounds by her. And the Lady Raiders are with an aggressive press right now, and which resulted in a turnover last possession. And number 14 up for the Southerners, and they beat the press. And hopefully they're trying to set up something at the top to shake the nerves. Number 14, Gardner's at the top of the key. Kicks it to number 10, Kayla Robbins. And number 4, Julian Allen. And they're just swinging the ball around. Kicks to number 10, sees 35 open, and just a lot of movement around the top of the three-point line. Number 14 drives, but great defense by the Lady Raiders, and that's just great defense as the Wakuri Daniels gets a ball or a hand on the ball to result in the good defensive play. Inbound for the Southerners as number 4, and she kicks it to the corner. Number 14, nice positioning by number 13, but the defense for Lady Raiders was great. Fortunately, she gets a step on Layla Eliotti, but number 3, Riley Pena, is pushing it with pace to try to get the Southerners not set on defense, and it works as she draws the foul. That is number 4 with the foul. And that was a shooting foul, so Riley Pena will go to the line for 2 free throws. And the hustle by Riley Pena on that to just see that the defense wasn't set. What do you think about that?
Yeah, she's been hustling all year, just making the other team foul her whenever she gets the ball in open field. Just great hustler.
Yes.
Great ball player.
She knocks down both those free throws to push the lead to 4-2. And the press is just very aggressive by Lady Raiders as it results in a jump ball. Great defense. That is Lady Raider ball. And number 1 is inbounding. And these Lady Raiders have been playing really good defense right now. This press has been killer for the Southerners.
They've been playing this defense all year, and it's really making all the teams turn it over. They've got great defense. Their offense is great, but I think the defense carries this team.
Yeah, very, very gritty defense. And kicks it to Wakuri Daniels. Open at the top of the key, and just a little strong on that. But Natasha Oliver saves it. But it appears that number 13 intercepts a pass to Demaria Daniels. Number 14, Garner's taking it up, and they're trying to set up something right now. And the two forwards for the Southerners are showing that they are a great team right now, using their screens to full advantage on the undersized Lady Raiders. But Lady Raiders showing a lot of heart and with their defense that it doesn't matter the size, they're doing great. Kicks it to number 10, and they're just moving around the three-point line. Number 35 with the screen, but kicks it to number 4. number 35 to number 14. Tries to thinks about a shot, and she does after a step, but off the backboard, not hitting rim. Riley Pena pushing it yet again. Kicks it to Layla Eliotti. That's her sweet spot, corner three, and just hits the inside of the rim. Good hustle, though, to get the offensive board. And number three drives to the paint and just gets a nice, ooh, nice wow. English on that. Just, yeah, nice kiss off the glass. Just great way to use all of the rolling on the ball. She just knows how to put the touch on it.
She can drive to the bucket and get the shot. She usually gets the foul right there, but she's just a great scorer.
It doesn't even matter. She's that good. Number 14, maybe trying to draw up something for the Southerners. Kicks it to number four. And looking for the inside man, but Natasha Oliver is playing great defense right now. Number 10 drives along the walks on the baseline, and they are just figuring it out. Ooh. And that is a bucket for number 10, Callie Robbins, and that is an and one. Unfortunately for Damari Daniels, she was out of position and had to result in a foul. And due to that, number 10, Sydney Crippen, has checked into the game for Damari Daniels. And number 10 is shooting her free throw and makes it. Score is 6-5 right now. And the Lady Raiders are taking it up the court. Kicks it to Wakiria Daniels. And a end around to Riley Pena on the baseline. Layla at the top of the key drives. Kicks it to Riley Painter for the same play. They're trying to figure something out, try to get her open. But Wakaria is very open. Pump fakes, drives. And they're just swinging the ball right now. Riley Pena got the ball, thought about it.
They're just having great runs right now. Great pick and rolls, great passes.
Yeah,
just controlling the game right now.
Yeah, they're moving around, trying to get a good shot, taking their time. And, oh, it worked perfectly as Wakiria Daniels. Open look. And that's a basket, a three-point basket for Wakiria Daniels. And that just shows that the Lady Raiders, their patience has paid off. The press. And a push-off for number 13, Sydney Crippen absorbing. Sydney Crippen absorbing that offensive foul. So number 13 is called for the offensive foul. Great defense by the Lady Raiders yet again. And they're trying to move the ball around yet again. And she goes up for the shot, but comes a little short on the rim. Still playing good defense. And number 14's taking it up, their point guard for the Southerners. 9-5, close game. And number 4 has got it at the letter. And number 13 at the three-point line. Good defense by Wakiria Daniels makes her pick up her dribble, but... And now they got her all out of sorts. Great defense by the Raiders. Number 14's got the ball to reset this. Tries to drive. But yet again, excellent defense by Sydney Crippen. Her second offensive foul of the game. And it's not even been the end of the first quarter. She is playing great right now.
What more could you ask on the defense? She's just taking those fouls and then getting the turnover for Nettleton, just give us another chance to score.
Yes. It just shows the great team player that she is, that she puts her body on the line just for a possession. She's just great. Number 24, Wakiria Daniels, and Sydney Crippen attacks. And, oh, she tried to do a nice threading the needle, but it results in a jump ball as number 11 checked in the game for the Lady Raiders. Number 11, Morris. And it was a jump ball resulting in the Southerners. So... Number 14 is, they're trying to beat the press right now with number 14 and 13. And intercepted by number 11, Morris. And she kicks it out to Sydney Crippen for the three-pointer. And, oh, just rims out. Very unfortunate. But number 14 trying to beat the press before it can even get set. And in transition, number 35 kicks it number 10 wide open. And a little out. Rims out yet again. Number 24 pushing it for Wakiria Daniels, and sees a hole, and good defense by number 10. Just got a hand on that. But a foul on Briley Pena. And that slows down the game. It was very high high tempo. What do you think, Daniel?
Yes, it was a fast-paced game. I think the Raiders were trying to slow it down.
Yeah, they were. they were trying to take advantage of the both teams were trying to take advantage of the transition, but weren't getting successful at the transition. Number 14 takes it, tries to make something happen. Number 4 kicks it. Oh, open shot, slightly contested. Bradley Pena with the offensive rebound. Drives and easy bucket in transition. Bradley Pena. And that's just easy right there. Transition buckets for the Lady Raiders. And back to that press. Layla playing great defense on the in the backcourt. Ooh, tried to swipe that ball away. But unfortunately, oh, never mind. Number 10 is open. Got the ball in the corner. A nice move by number 4 to get by the defender. However, great help defense. And it looked like number 4 was thinking about it. 14, excuse me, was thinking about it. But number 4 with the shot. And it is good, as that is a three-pointer. And they are trying to get a ball off, but they can't get the shot off. As the final score of the first quarter is a Nettleton Lady Raiders 11, the Southside Southerners 8. We are going to go to commercial break. This is Nettleton Television watching the Lady Raiders. Don't go anywhere.
The first time you held on to the time you let go. Life is a series of unforgettable firsts, the ones that are planned and the ones that take you by surprise. We celebrate and support these firsts as we travel this journey with you, because firsts are what life is all about. First Community Bank, where community comes first.
And we're back on Nettleton Television as the Lady Raiders have inbounded the ball and are setting up the offense. Number 24, Wakiria Daniels, kicks it to number 4, Demaria Daniels. And a nice floater, like she had success with the first time, but was a little off on that, but her got her own board. Thinks about it from Wakiria Daniels. Another open shot by Demaria, and that is a little short as well. Number 14 pushing it, or taking it, the ball up the court. And they're trying to take their time right now. Very close game, Dana. What do you think?
Yes, it's a close game, just like I thought it would be. Both teams have one loss, so you knew it would come down to the wire. Wow.
She throws up a shot, and Lele puts her body out, but no foul either way. Demaria gets the ball, pushes it, kicks it to Wakiria Daniels in the corner, and off, but Lele gets the board and goes for the putback, comes up short, and 14 takes the ball up the court. She's setting up a play, maybe incorporating a screen from 35 or 13. And, oh, kicks it to the elbow for number 13, drives baseline. And great defense by Natasha Oliver, getting her out of the paint. Oh, and number 10, top of the key, back to 4. And 14 gets a nice screen from number 35, but doesn't go anywhere by the gritty defense of the Lady Raiders. 14's got it. Another screen by 35. And the pick does not work, as she comes up short with that. And Layla gets the defensive board. Riley Pena with a move and gets the foul. The shooting foul on, it appears to be number 13. Number 4 got the foul. Yeah, so Bradley Pena is going to be at the line for 2 free throws. And that is her, sinks the first one. And that she makes her second one. What does that tally up to, Daniel?
Bradley Pena has 8 points for the game right now. She's just going crazy on the offense.
And I think half of those are from the free throw line.
Yes, they are. She's had two layups and then four free throws she's made. She's just doing good. She's perfect on the free throws.
Oh, great defense by Lady Raiders. But unfortunately, as Bradley Pena pokes the ball out, number 10 just luckily in the spot to put the ball back in the hoop. And they're trying to slow it down, Lady Raiders. And they're just handing the ball off to one another, trying to just get some people open. DeMario with a nice step. Kicks it to Akiri Daniels in the corner. Drives. Good defense by number 10. Number one, Layla Eliotti loses a dribble, kicks it to DeMario Daniels, and maybe they're trying to set it up again. 24 with a drive and the floater, and nice kiss off the glass as she banks it in, which puts the Lady Raiders up 15-10, and the press is yet again on that pesky little press. And number 14 is drawing up something. And a screen appears to be from number 13, but she bounces out. Number 4 shoots the 3 from the corner, or wing, and Natasha Oliver gets the board. Bradley Pena pushing it. Number 4, DeMario Daniels. Natasha Oliver gets the ball at the top and lets Bradley Pena set up something. And let's see what they draw up to get an open shot. And a nice move by Wakiria Daniels. And she just got number 13 thinking that they were going to go around the screen, but she gets Natasha Oliver's faux screen and just drives to the lane. That was beautiful. Number 4 doing a little movement, comes up short from that shot in the paint. And, a nice little pull-up from Bradley Pena as she drives down and gets a pull-up. And after the timeout, we are going to go with them. This is Lady Raider Basketball on NTV.
Raiders have wrecks they call collision repair. Back in 1986, Nettleton's Jeff Edgar was smashing baseballs. He hit the first home run in Raider baseball history. These days, he's fixing smash cars at Collision Repair. Collision Repair's staff is second to none, and their facilities are world-class. They'll get you fixed up and back on the road in no time. Collision Repair, it's where the Raiders go when the Raiders have wrecks.
That whatever it takes for every child, but really we mean that. You know, it's not something that we just say, and we don't take that lightly. At the end of the day, I want them to love school. I want them to love and appreciate that our school is willing to go above and beyond to do whatever we can to teach them. But my bottom line goal is to teach them to love school and love learning and become a lifelong learner, just like I try to be.
I'm a little bit country.
And we are back as the Nettleton Lady Raiders are up 19-10 on the Southside Southerners, and it appears to be the Southerners' ball.
Bradley Pena is leading the Lady Raiders in scoring with 10 points this game. She's doing great offensively, drawing the fouls, making layups. She's having a great game this first half.
If that's a sign of things to come, then that's very promising for the Lady Raiders. Number 14 with the drive on Wakiri Daniels and a foul on Wacky D, I believe. Yes, it's a foul on number 24. And they called it on the floor, so not a shooting foul, as they inbound it to number 14 in the corner. And she was wide open. I guess nobody picked her up. And that is a three-pointer on number 14. In the game, number 12. Akira James. Cindy Crippen, they're just moving the ball around as Demaria kicks it to Okuria. Natasha Oliver kicks it to Akira James. And she loses the dribble as Southerners show really good defense. Number 14 in transition. Kicks it and tries to get number 4, but Sydney Crippen with the defense, but a loose ball. Number 13 saves it, but Demaria gets the interception. What a sequence right there.
Just got to keep it with it and you'll get the ball.
Joseph, even if you think the play's dead, you still go for the ball, and there may have been, 3 changes of possession right there, but great defense by or hustle by both sides, resulting in Demario Daniels getting the ball. And in the corner, Wakiria Daniels, and it comes up a little short on that corner three. Number four pushing it in transition. Up at the top, number 35. Passes it to number 14. She's got a bit of a hot hand, doesn't she, Daniel?
Yeah, she does. She's made a three already this quarter.
And, yeah, that was a big three. Their first points of the – or, excuse me, not their first points, but
– of this quarter.
Yeah. Number four waiting, tries to get good positioning, but she throws it right into three Lady Raiders, and that results in a jump ball. And I believe that is, yes, Lady Raider basketball. Excuse me, that is the Southerners ball. Sorry, my apologies. As number four inbounds it. And a lot of, she just throws it up to number 14. Good job of not getting a 5 second. And goes for the scoop layup, but comes up short. Kyra James pushing it. And a nice dish to Natasha Oliver. Great vision by Kyra James to give it to Natasha Oliver for the wide open bucket. And number 13. Kicks it number 14. Number 14 doing great handling the ball. Brett Gardner. And it appears that there was a foul on the shot. So number 14, Brett Gardner, will go to the line, shooting two shots, and the foul was on number 25, Natasha Oliver. And does not hit the first one. So she has one more since it was a shooting foul. And again, does not come up with that one as Natasha gets the board. And, you know, Wakiria Daniels for three off, but Kyra James with the board. Wakiria Daniels seems to be a little off from three. But it's good because the Lady Raiders got the rebound, and Riley Pena seems to be maybe attempting to go for the last shot. With
50 seconds left,
yeah,
just dribbling the clock down. If they don't pressure, there's no reason to go with them.
I guess they're going to go let her as about 35 seconds left right now.
I think they're just going to let her dribble out the clock.
I think they're going to go for a shot.
The Southerners aren't applying any defense, so, I mean.
They want them. I guess they're rather relying on hardcore defense instead of resulting in a mistake that leads to an open basket. And 15 seconds right now in the second quarter, and they're setting it up now. And they're moving it around number 10 to Sydney Crippen to Kyra James. Riley Pena takes a shot, highly contested, results in a not hitting the rim. Good defense by Kyra James and Sydney Crippen, and she does not get it off. However, that was close. But your final score, or the final score of the first half, is Nettleton Lady Raiders 21, Southside Southerners 13, and this has been Lady Raider basketball on.
Say that whatever it takes for every child, but really we mean that. You know, it's not something that we just say, and we don't take that lightly. At the end of the day, I want them to love school. I want them to love and appreciate that our school is willing to go above and beyond to do whatever we can to teach them. But my bottom line goal is to teach them to love school and love learning and become a lifelong learner, just like I try to be.
I'm a little bit country.
I'm a little bit rock and roll.
I love that high throw feeling of a great rock.
When I sing my alma mater, I feel it all night long.
I love my school with all my heart and soul.
I know I'm gonna be all right.
Wherever I go.
I'm a little bit country.
And a little bit rock and roll.
Are you worried about losing your Raider pride? Then you need Raider Pride Alert. Just press the button on the Class of 89 Spirit Stick, and we will send help immediately.
Raider Pride Alert.
Help! My Raider Pride is fallen and it can't get up!
It's okay, Miss Timmerman. Help is on the way.
Turn up, turn up! Raider Pride, we got some.
Raider Pride, we got some. To order your Raider Pride alert, just call 1-800-RP-ALERT. Raider Pride is justified.
Looking for a school can be like super overwhelming. You kind of have those fears as a parent that, oh my gosh, the school that I'm gonna pick, it's gonna determine their future and everything else. And, you know, it's a big choice that you have because you wanna make sure you're gonna put them in a school where they can continue their whole journey. I'm really super glad we started at Nettleton. It was relief that we had found a school where we felt comfortable sending our child. I felt like any situation he'd get put into, he would be able to succeed.
Uh-oh, guess what day it is? Guess what day it is? Huh? Anybody? Julie, hey, guess what day it is? Oh, come on, I know you can hear me. Mike. What day is it, Mike? Hey, Leslie, guess what day it is?
It's game day.
Woo-hoo!
Jalen, how happy are students that go to Nettleton?
I'll say happier than DJ on game day.
Game day!
Be happy, be a Raider. Raider pride is justified.
So don't forget it.
Mr. Miller lost his voice. No problem. I'll send in the replacements.
Ooh! Woo, Daddy Mercy. Mercy, woo, Daddy. Handsome Johnny. How the heck do you edit on this thing?
Mr. McGrew, you're in photo booth.
What? This son of a...
Hey, that's all right. Good try. But I'll take it from here. Raider pride
is justified.
They say being a Raider is about more than just going to school. They say being a Raider is about our community, about tradition. Kindergarten at Nettleton is about teachers that I love, learning that is fun. It's really about pride in what we do and who we are becoming. Raider pride is justified. Raider pride forever.
Nettleton students will do anything for the Spirit State.
Would you ding-dong ditch Coach Massey?
That old man, any day.
Dad, coming!
Would you get tased by Officer Watts?
Yes.
Okay. Raider pride.
Would you cannonball into the Raider River?
Would I? Hold my mullet.
We are Raiders. Bum ba dum bum 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 bum.
Did you hear that?
Yeah, it sounds like we're in a Raider Pride ad. That means something awesome's about to happen.
Raider Pride, brother, fire that thing in here. Dinger!
Hey, run.
At Nettleton, we got that Raider Pride.
Because Raider Pride is justified.
We are Raiders. Bum ba dum bum 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 bum.
What the heck?
Yeah, I'm a junior. Does it matter? You do that for me? Really? Oh, how like that.
Who are you talking to?
It's DJ from Nettleton.
That sounds like a really good deal.
DJ from Nettleton at 3 in the morning? Who is this?
It's DJ from Nettleton.
What are you wearing?
Every Nettleton student, when they hear it. A higher calling. An invitation to achieve. To excel. To be a part of something bigger than themselves. It's the calling of greater pride. And it's alive and well at Nettleton, where Raider pride is justified.
I first noticed it when he started school here at Nettleton.
There he is.
Who's got that Raider pride? We've got that Raider
pride, brother. Proud, brother.
So we're going to pick up today chapter 23. Can anybody tell me what page that's on?
89.
Salo, why are you the way that you are?
But you know, some of the stuff he does is actually pretty cool.
Here's Jimmy.
Who's Jimmy?
Raider Pride can't save you from becoming Mr. Miller, but it can give you the best high school experience ever. Raider Pride is justified.
Yeah, we Raiders got the comfort ship, a loaded. Everybody wants to be a show, a voting. Raider Pride in the building, yeah, yeah, I know it. Ah, yeah, Raider Nation till the day it's over.
Raider Pride, justified, got it on my side. Six side, be the guy, run up and you get a high. Press us the ball.
and almost score like
woo. What y'all know about fifth period Raider pride? Hop up on the field, you might just have a juke and job. Every day, yeah, I rep the five. Cause yeah, you know we fifth period, yeah, we make it live.
Why?
Tell them what you got.
I got that Raider pride.
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 I got that Raider pride. Tell them what you got.
I got that Raider pride.
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 I got that Raider pride. Tell them what you got.
I got that. I got that. I got that Raider pride.
Tell them what you got.
Yeah, I got that. I got that. I got that Raider pride.
Our school's pretty amazing.
I know. Kind of makes you just want to
break into song.
I like the faculty.
I like NTV.
I like the principal.
Although he paddled me.
We love the black hole.
We love our sports teams.
Raider pride, Raider pride, Raider pride, Raider pride.
I like the lunch room.
I like learning.
We love that.
And welcome to the Consolidated Insurance Halftime Show. This has been a great game by the Lady Raiders. It is 21-13 Lady Raiders. And Daniel, let's hear some of those stats.
Yeah, Briley Pena is leading the Raiders with 10 points. And then Walkeria Daniels has 7 for the game. In the first quarter, we did pretty good, scoring 11 points. In the second quarter, we only scored one less than that with 10.
A good, consistent pace right now. And let's hear about those Southerners.
The Southerners have 13 points for the game. Number 4 has 3 points, and their leading scorer is Callie Robbins. She has 5 points.
An even distribution of the scoring for the Southerners. And it's definitely been it was competitive in the first quarter, being 11-8, but as the second quarter started, they just came out with a head of steam.
Yep.
Lady Raiders had 10 points, and the Southerners had 5. And as we're about to start the start of the third quarter, don't go anywhere because we got some action ready to go. And it looks like they're about to inbound the ball to Layla Eliotti.
It has changed since the 1950s. But one thing has remained the same. Sue's Drugstore is still keeping Nettleton healthy. Albert and Shirley Sue founded Sue's Drug in 1959, and today their grandson Tyler continues their tradition of fast, friendly, professional service. Sue's Drug Store, keeping Raider pride healthy and alive since 1959.
And inbounding the ball is Wakiria Daniels, kicks it to Briley Pena. While we were out, it was a foul on Kelly Robbins, but it was on the floor, so the Lady Raiders gained possession, or still have possession. And Briley Pena is at the top. Kicks it to Layla Eliotti, trying to move the ball around. That's what they do best. Number 4 gets Briley Pena with an open look and was off a little bit. Wakiria Daniels with the offensive board and a bully move, but comes up short. And number 13, Kimmy Jenkins, kicks it to number 14, Brett Gardner. Number 4 kicks to number 10. And Gardner takes it. Looks for Olivia Allen. Kicks it to Robbins. Gardner drives on Wakiria Daniels and throws up a wild shot. Gets her own board, but Natasha just gets the ball. She had it, but and then the Lady Raiders gain possession as Wakiria. Natasha Oliver goes through her legs. That is a wild sequence.
That
number
was
14 with a stutter step on the shot, but comes up short. Layla Eliotti pushes it, throws up a
dime.
A dime. Couldn't hold on to it. And a timeout called by the Lady Raiders, and we'll go with them. That is the Timeout, lay your Raiders. You're watching them on NTV. And we are back as it is Lady Raider ball as they call timeout before the break. Layla is inbounding for the Raiders. Gets Wakiria Daniels in a beautiful play drawn up to get Wakiria Daniels open on the cut to the basket. And that's a good bucket for her.
That's her ninth point of the day. Her and Briley Pena are just doing great on offense for the Raiders.
That's usually how it is, Briley Pena and Wakiria Daniels. The Southerners beat the press. And number four drives with a looked like an attempt at an acrobatic layup, but comes up short as she goes into three Lady Raiders. Riley Pena drives, draws contact, and that sends her to the free throw line to shoot two. And the foul is on number 10, Callie Robinson. That is her second foul. And Briley Pena at the line shooting and sinks the first one.
That's Briley's 11th point of the day and fifth free throw made.
And potentially six. That just shows that she gets to the free throw line pretty efficiently, and that's her sixth. And not only does she get to the line excellently, she is very
perfect,
very efficient, yes. Six for six. And press, great defense by the Lady Raiders. And through number 10's legs. What a break for the Lady Raiders. And Natasha Oliver inbounding the ball. Layla taking it up. Layla Eliotti. And Damari Daniels gets the handoff. Wakiria Daniels drives. And she appeared to have taken one too many steps, resulting in a turnover for the Lady Raiders and Southerners ball. And that press is yet again persistent, and they are almost and they beat the press before the backcourt or 18 second violation. Number 10 gets it. They're just moving the ball around. Number 4, Olivia Allen, drives, kicks it. Number 13, foot into the 3-point line, but Sydney Crippen gets the defensive board. Layla holds the ball and then tries to set something up. Who's it? A great find of Damari Daniels, but she doesn't take it. Gets Wakiria Daniels. Layla tries she got the ball, but off a questionable pass like that one. Sydney Crippen goes up. Number 4 got the ball and transition, and Sydney tried to play good defense, and that results in a foul on the floor. I don't know. I guess Sydney Crippen thought it was a backcourt, but instead of getting the ball, number 4 showed great hustle to go after Olivia Allen, go after it, and that results in a foul for the Lady Raiders. Number 13 looking for a screen. And throws up something that doesn't even hit iron. And Briley Pena in transition. And comes up a little strong on that. No need to fear, though. Akira James for the Lady Raiders gets the offensive board. And they try to set up something. You never really see Briley Pena miss those. Just a good defense by the Southside Southerners. Layla thought about it. She can't seem to get a good look today. Kyra James. And there is a foul. It appears, yes, there's an offensive foul. Offensive foul on the Nettleton Raiders. Damaria Daniels picks up a foul.
Her second foul of the day.
Resulting in Southerners ball. And wow. Bradley Pena got her hand on that one. And it number 35 had a nice look but didn't finish. Great hustle by Bradley Pena to get her hand on that.
The Lady Raiders defense just got him off balance and made her mess up the shot right there.
Just enough to, like you said, mess up the shot. Layla looking for number 11 and draws a foul. So that's number 14, Brett Gardner with the foul. That's her second. But it was on the floor, so the Lady Raiders inbound. Riley Pena gets us the inbound and comes up a little short yet again. Just hits the front of the rim. Number 14 goes across the half-court line with it. And at the three-point line, number 4, Olivia Allen gets it. A fadeaway, a little short. Oh, number 13 showing some bully ball as she just reaches over two Lady Raiders and pulls that down. Unfortunately, Lady Raiders tipped it out of her hand, so it's still Southerner's ball. And near 5 seconds, but gets it out to number 10, Callie Robbins. Gardner kicks it to Allen. Back to Robbins. And number 35 gets at the three-point line, fumbles the ball. Brett Gardner kicks it to Allen. Gardner back to Allen. Goes cross court, number 35 with a three, and doesn't have the touch on it. Riley Payne drives. And an offensive foul, apparently. I think Riley Payne might have pushed off a little, or maybe caught an elbow to someone's jaw, and that's not allowed. That's Riley Payne with a foul.
Oh, ooh, good defense.
Yeah, that was great defense on the other end.
Just made up for that turnover right
exactly.
There.
Exactly. Yeah, it shows the hustle. You know, she gets.
She wants the ball.
She wants it. She gets called for the foul. She keeps her head up and looks for the next play.
Wow.
Man, drives the baseline and got a nice look for her people or for her teammates, but they just weren't able to hit it.
Briley Pena slowing down the play right here.
And that just shows what kind of quarter it's been. They are, the Southerners are scoreless in this quarter. As a, appears to be a moving screen for number 11, Kadeja Morris. That's her first foul. And having a bit of trouble. That's her second offensive foul on our second possession. Hopefully the Lady Raiders can clean this up. As yet again caught in the transition, Lady Raiders get caught. But they show good defense except for that time, as it appears someone gets called for the reach-in foul. And that's Bradley Pena with the reach-in foul. And I think that's actually in the bonus. That puts him in the bonus. No, not yet. Excuse me. I guess that was a shooting foul. My apologies. So it was a shooting foul Bradley Pena caused. So that results in 13 at the free throw line, and she sinks the first one. That's their first points of the third quarter. Comes up short on the second one. Number 32 checks into the game. Kasia Burns. Wakiria gets the ball from Briley. Tasia at the top. Briley gets a nice screen from Natasia. And definitely gets a lot of contact on that play from number 35, Madison Gilmore, resulting in a foul. And Bradley Pena at the line. And I feel like we've heard this narrative before. Bradley Pena at the line, if you know what I mean.
That's Bradley Pena's fourth time to go to the line. And she's perfect.
Yeah, I believe she hits both of them.
Has 4 points this quarter, all off of free throws.
That's
perfect
awesome.
For the night.
That's good. And the defense by Lady Raiders, very aggressive. And I appear that they did not cross the half-court line in time. Beautiful press by Lady Raiders. Yeah, that's just good defense right there. Just getting them, you know, out of position. Or just getting them frazzled enough that they couldn't even cross the line. That's just stellar defense.
That's just
hard screen Raiders, from number 32. Excuse me, Zane.
That's just what the Raiders defense has been doing all year.
A nice roll from Natasha, but she gets blocked by number 13. That was a nice pick and roll. And there's a foul on number 25. Natasha Oliver. I guess she didn't. Got a little handsy after that. Tried to make up for it. Maybe reached in. And that press, yet again, is being dirty. But they beat it this time at least. And a steal. Picked the ball out, number 25, and Briley Pena recovered by Layla, and Briley Pena scores on the other end. And that's just good team ball right there.
That's Briley Pena's 6th point of this quarter.
16th of the game, and they throw it out of bounds. Lady Raiders are playing on all cylinders, firing on all cylinders, playing great. I don't know, man. I feel like they're looking unstoppable right now.
They're looking like the state champs that they are.
Exactly. Demario Daniels checks in for Kasia Burns. And they're trying to draw something up. Yeah, they're moving with a little tempo, trying to, you know, carry this momentum as Layla gets the corner three. That's her sweet spot.
Oh.
But, and that is the end of the quarter. I got caught off track by that. Go for the extra point, but that is the end of the quarter. Final, the score of the third is 29-14 Lady Raiders. You're watching Nettleton Raider basketball on NTV.
It's changed since the 1950s. But one thing has remained the same. Sue's Drugstore is still keeping Nettleton healthy. Albert and Shirley Sue founded Sue's Drug in 1959, and today their grandson Tyler continues their tradition of fast, friendly, professional service. Sue's Drug Store, keeping Raider pride healthy and alive since 1959.
And we're back right now, going into the fourth quarter of this good game from the Nettleton Raiders, Lady Raiders, and the Southside Southerners. We'd like to thank our sponsors real quick. First Community Bank, Russell's Truck Accessories, Shadrachs Collision Repair, Delta Seed Plane Company, Sue's Drugstore, Consolidated Insurance, and Trish Merritt from A Beautiful Mess Salon. And tried to poke the ball out, Briley Pena. As Southerners set up, they play at the top of the key. And Daniel, what do you think about the consistent play of
the offense? Raiders have scored 11, 10, and 8 through the first three quarters. Pretty consistent on the offense. And then their defense just showed up the third quarter, letting the Southerners only score off of one free throw.
And right there, Briley Pena got her third foul and inbounded. And with two opportunities, the Southerners come up short. Wakiria Daniels gets the ball as Briley Pena takes it up. Gets Wakiria Daniels on an open look, but cannot hit it. She just hasn't been able to hit those, has she?
No. But she's still getting the layups and
comes up short on that one.
The rebounds.
Hopefully, if we come up short, they do too. Demario Daniels with the open transition move.
A dime from Briley Pena.
And Demario gets it in transition. Just got down at the other end of the court to finish. Easy points for the Lady Raiders. Defense is like pit bull defense as it bounces off the Southerner, number 4, Olivia Allen's foot, rolling out of bounds. Great defense from the Raiders as Layla inbounds the ball. And Briley Pena takes it up for the Lady Raiders. Wakiria with a big defender in her face. Ooh, nice move by Bradley Pena. Got number four looking around the screen. Demaria with a pump, jumps, and again, Latasia got a nice clean pass from Demaria, but number 13 is so tall, she blocked Demaria, or Natasia, excuse me. And with a 17-point lead right now for the Lady Raiders, all they have to do is just play good ball. That's number 13. Kami Jenkins gets the nice move, an all pump fake and a nice little mid-range shot. And that appears to be your second bucket of the game.
Her fourth point of the game. And, oh, wow. Demaria Daniels is doing good this quarter.
Yeah, she in the first quarter, she had a beautiful play with a floater.
Starting the Raiders off strong.
Yeah.
First points of the game.
Exactly. Now she yet again has successful luck with the floater as she drops one in. And they're just moving the ball around right now, trying to get something to stop the bleeding, get something working on offense. A nice, good defense by Wakiria Daniels. Briley Pena is hustling with the ball and takes it herself.
Oh.
A little strong on that, though, but she had a good look.
Comes back on defense.
She tried to make up for it as number four gets the ball in the corner. 24 checks in. I did not see that. Kerrigan Cossie. Number four, Olivia Allen, drives. A little strong off the glass. Layla gets the board. Number four, Demaria Daniels gets the ball, kicks to Layla, back to Briley. Layla gets a look.
Oh, and there she goes.
She third time's a charm as she splashes that three-pointer from her spot. That's her first points of the game. Unfortunately, though, she does get the foul as she tries to make a play for the ball. Unfortunately, make drawing contact. That's her first. Wakiria checks out, and Sydney Kripa takes her spot. She played great so far. Wakiria Daniels.
Yes, she has. Wakiria has 9 points for the
Later
game.
Oh, right, yeah, now. Yes. And that is number four at the line. Shooting a 1-1, and Olivia Allen hits the first to lead to a second opportunity at the free throw line. And sinks them both. That's 18 points for the Southerners. Great defense by the Lady Raiders, only allowing 18 points in the game. They're just playing great.
Yes, their defense is lights out this year. Just shutting every team down at half court, making the teams turn over the ball, just working them.
And that time, she draws contact. Natasha Oliver gets a nice pass in the inside and draws contact enough for the draw foul. To go to the free throw line, that was number 24 with the foul. I believe that's her first. Natasha shooting her first. And a sinks the first one.
That's Natasha's third point for the night. Let's hope she can get the fourth with this free throw. Oh,
and a little off, but it's okay. One for two on that. One of two. Number four, Olivia Allen gets the ball. Good. A little pocket picker right there. Riley Pena pokes that free. And there is an offensive foul on number 13. Kami Jenkins with the foul. Kami Jenkins' second foul of the game. And Lady Raiders are causing a lot of miscues on the offensive side of the ball for the Southerners. What do you think, Daniel?
Yes, their defense has just been pressuring them the whole game, making them make turnovers, making them slow down and get off their rhythm.
They're really controlling the game.
Yes, you can tell. One team's a state champion.
Layla with the shot. A little off, but Sydney with the rebound. And sets it back up to Brelly. She tries to make something happen a little behind the back action. and they're just maybe trying to chew a little clock. And Sydney with a drive takes it all by herself with beautiful English on that ball, able to get it going, and it rolls in for the and one. That's Olivia Allen on the foul. And Sydney Crippen at the line shooting a one. And comes up a little short on that one. Number 11 in the game, Morris. And a foul on the shot for number 14. And Jadeja Morris gets her second foul of the game with that one. And number 14 at the line shooting two shots. Comes up short on the first one. So she misses the first and has the opportunity to get the second. And sinks it. Number 11 gives it to number 12. And number 12 takes in a Kyra James for Briley Pena. And it looks like a 20-point lead right now for Lady Raiders. This looks good. Ooh. That's number 13.
13's just been stopping them from coming into the paint this game.
A vicious shot blocker. And I know she's had three or four blocks that I can think of as number 14 short. Demaria tries to redeem herself as she easily takes it in transition for
her
the
sixth point of this quarter.
Wow. She's definitely been a presence on offense this quarter. 41-19, Lady Raider ball, or excuse me, Lady Raider lead. And number four tries to get a nice positioning, but a blocking foul on Layla Eliotti. I guess she didn't have her feet set. So number one is for the Lady Raiders. Layla Eliotti gets the foul. Third of the night as there are some substitutions in. Number 13 at the line. Number 13 is at the line shooting two. Allie Linderman is checked into the game as well as, I can't really read her number right now.
23,
excuse me.
Kyla Williams.
As they get the offensive board and look for a second chance opportunity, Allie Linderman kicks it to Kyra James. And looks like it's a good Lady Raider victory so far. I don't want to get my hopes up or anything, but Allie Linderman gets the ball. Gets a nice screen from number 11. But Sydney Crippen saves that possession. Kyra James at the top. Nice move. Kicks it out to Allie Linderman. Allie Linderman kicks it back to Sydney Crippen at the top. She drives. Comes up a little long or a little strong on that one. Great defense, or great hustle by number 23 to get the offensive rebound. Same for Allie Linderman. She went to the other end, unfortunately. There was a... Oh, we're calling for a substitution right now as number 14 gets the basket. And number 12 inbounds it to number 23. And this just shows that the Lady Raiders are a really good team.
Yes, up by 20 points.
A convincing win. Good save by number 32. Tries to go off the glass. Number 11 cannot get it, but great hustle by number 32 yet again to get the jump ball as Vidalia McIntyre checks in for number 11. And the Lady Raiders are up by 20 as we inbound the ball to number 30. Or excuse me, number 23. Comes up a little strong on that layup. But number 30 gets the rebound. Allie Linderman shoots it from the corner. And that is a splash three-pointer from Allie Linderman.
That's her first points of the night.
It's good to see a sophomore getting some offense for the Lady Raiders. Number 24 kicks it to number 35. And number 10 gets at the top of the key. 3 seconds left. Number 25. And it looks like that is the end of the game. Your final score of this basketball game, Nettleton Lady Raiders 44, the Southside Southerners 21. Don't go anywhere for a post-game, Consolidated Insurance post-game show, as we are going to go to commercial break. This is Nettleton Lady Raider basketball on NTV.
First time you held on to the time you let go. Life is a series of unforgettable firsts. The ones that are planned and the ones that take you by surprise. We celebrate and support these firsts as we travel this journey with you. Because firsts are what life is all about. First Community Bank, where community comes first.
Was it? It was 44. No, I'm off by one. Or one bucket.
All right, 44-20. That's what it says.
Yeah, that's not 44. Allie Linderman got the three. 3, 4, 6, 12. Oh, here it is. Here it is. 15. Okay. Oh. Wait. 16.
You're ready?
No.
He said he written up.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 3, 4, 6, okay. 10, 16, 21. Yep, got it.
And we are back for the Nettleton Raider, or excuse me, Consolidated Insurance post-game show. As the Lady Raiders had a convincing 44-21 point victory over the Southside Southerners.
Yeah, the Lady Raiders were led by Briley Pena, scoring 16 points this game, and just hustling on defense, creating turnovers. Just the whole Lady Raiders defense was controlling this game. Demaria Daniels had 8 points, starting off the Raiders to have their first bucket of the game, starting the Lady Raiders offense. Wakiria Daniels had 9 points. And Allie Linderman, the sophomore, splashed a 3 right before the game ended.
Yeah, you love to see that. Yeah, with Briley Pena had the game high, 16 points. She was just a presence on not only offense and defense. She was getting steals, turnovers on the other end. Good hustle. Just that's what you get out of Briley Pena. Yeah. It's all you can ask for. For the Southerners.
Olivia Allen had 5 points for the game, but there was a tie for leading scorer Callie Robbins and Brett Gardner, both having 6 points. And the other scorer for the Southerners was Cammy Jenkins with 4 points.
Yeah, as you can tell, they struck a unfortunate blow at the beginning of the game as one of their starters was injured. And that was, you know, you can't really plan for that or draw that up, but they did their best, I believe.
They didn't have many subs, but they had to work with what they had.
Yes.
And they had us good at the start.
Yeah, they did. Talk about it.
It was 11-8 in the first quarter, but then we just put it on them into the second and third quarter, letting the Southerners only score 6 points in the second and third quarter combined, while we had 18 in the second and third quarter.
Yeah, they had, they had 8 points in the second half. As we had 8 in the third. They we just we really turned on the burners after after that first quarter. We just never looked back as the Lady Raiders won with a 44-21 victory. I'd like to thank the sponsors again. First Community Bank, Russell's Truck Accessories, Shadrachs Coffee, Collision Repair, Delta Seed Plane Company, Sue's Drugstore, Consolidated Insurance, and Trish Merritt from A Beautiful Mess Salon. Thank you so much for joining us this evening for some Lady Raider basketball. Thank you for watching on Nettleton Television, and we will see you again.
Oh, the marcher, hear the parting song.